We as LGBTQ2+ youth have a lot to say about gender-based violence, from how it impacts us to what we want to see done about it. But before we get into that, we should probably explain what gender-based violence, or GBV for short, is exactly. Gender-based violence is the way people use and abuse power and control against someone else based on their gender identity, gender expression, or perceived gender. Over the past 5 months, we've been connecting with other LGBTQ2+ youth across Canada through surveys, in-person consultations, and online meetings because we wanted to better understand how GBV impacts us and what we should be doing to stop it. Here's what we heard. Street harassment, bullying in schools, and a lack of public safety were big issues, especially for trans, gender non-conforming, and racialized LGBTQ2+ youth. Bad experiences with health and social services, unwelcoming families, negative media portrayals, and sexual violence were also extremely common issues and all too familiar ways our community felt the impacts of gender-based violence. But we wanted to learn more than what's wrong, so we also talked about what could be done better. We want more education for our peers, our parents, and the general public. We want better training for health providers, social service providers, teachers, and school officials to make these spaces and services safer. We want peer support programs and community spaces created by and for LGBTQ2+ youth. More than anything else, we want action to end LGBTQ2+ youth homelessness, as those facing homelessness are among the most vulnerable to gender-based violence. As LGBTQ2+ youth, we know what we need to make our community safer, healthier, and more inclusive. We know the problems, we live them every day, and we know the solutions too. It's time to listen to us, and that we all do more to end gender-based violence against LGBTQ2+ youth.